Hello everyone and welcome to Rags to Riches on Red Dead Redemption 2 online. And yeah, we're starting up today. I did say in some of the GTA Rags to Riches that I was going to bring this back on PC with a new character. So if you guys had watched episode 1, 2 or 3 of my Trash to Cash or Rags to Riches with Ethan. Rags to Riches with Ethan is possibly coming back. Not sure about that though. But Trash to Cash, it's gone completely. This is replacing it. We're going to get back up to speed to where we were on that, and hopefully we're going to bring this out a lot more consistently. And by that, I mean we're going to bring it out at least 2 times a week, along with the GTA stuff. So, yeah, you guys can look forward to that, and we're going to go through the best money-making methods that you guys can help me with and I can help you with in the future. And, yeah, so there's not really too much else that I need to say, apart from I've already done the character, I've already done the attributes, I've already sorted out the whistle, so you guys don't have to worry about character creation. Yeah, and we can just jump straight in.
If it's all correct, I'll take a photograph. Bring your hands up onto your chest.
So, on the Rags to Riches stuff with Ethan, I read a lot of the comments on some of the old, well, on the episodes that we did, and a lot of people complained about the amount that we spoke over the cutscenes, so I'm gonna try and not speak over cutscenes in this. Purely because I know quite a lot of people still haven't got to the point where we're probably going to get in GTA. In Red Dead, sorry. So I'm not going to speak of the cutscenes. You guys can enjoy them as much as possible. We have got subtitles on as well, so if I do accidentally say something, you guys can see the subtitles too. Or if it wasn't very clear, you don't have to worry about going back and watching. I'm going to assume most of you have seen this bit though, right?
Kitchen's ain't staff. Officer Townsend, those rocks ain't gonna break themselves. What are you standing there for? Get moving. What are you looking at? Go on, get moving.
You with the hammer, and you'll do. You need to perform a work detail out near Blackwater. Come on, get in. Open the gate.
The majestic ginger beast. Here he is. Okay, so to those of you that are wondering as well, we are live on Twitch. So if you guys go check the description, you guys can come tune into these episodes and the GTA ones live.
Lot stay calm in there.
You aren't saying nothing.
Well, you are now. Shut up. You know, my wife has acquired ideas significantly above her station. She's been reading too many goddamn books. Personally, I'm against education. With women, I mean. And men, I guess. Unnecessary. Doesn't add much to the world. Education.
What a dumbass.
Good day, gentlemen. Oh. Don't do anything stupid. Nobody gets shot. Act like fools, and the pair of you will be dead within a minute. Now, what are your names?
Jenkins and Milliken.
Well, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken, throw your guns to the ground and get on down here. That's it. Very glad to meet you. It's not worth being rash. Boys get paid a salary. You get that salary whether these people escape or not. Your wives presumably want you alive. Let them out. Now, please.
Okay. Okay.
You all run away. Aside from you. Try to stay out of trouble. This is a stroke of good fortune for all of you. Use it. Now, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken, be so kind as to quickly run away before somebody gets shot entirely unnecessarily. Go on, send him at second. Mr. Wendt, I believe it was $50 we agreed on.
It was.
Here's 50 each.
Each?
Yes. Now get out of here, both of you. My employer and I appreciate your professionalism.
All we did was stand there and look tough.
And you did it fantastically well. Good day, gentlemen. Now, sir. How about you pick up these guns? and we move out. My mistress is waiting for us. Come along. And you better get on this horse.
Which horse? Oh, over there. I'd like to know what my guy did. Why was he in prison? Did we just leave that to the imagination?
They haven't got far to ride.
My horse died. Sure.
Come along. Then you better get on this horse.
I actually never saw his name pop up, so.
Much of an animal, but they haven't got far to ride. Ready? Wonderful. I hope you'll forgive the secrecy. My employer particularly values discretion. My name is Mr. Horley, by the way.
Oh, whoa. Secret. Whoa.
Hey, come on. Ride with me.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Can we go now? Okay. Try and start a new one. You'll have money in your pocket to go to the store with, and there'll be chances to make more if that's what you're after. And chances to raise hell, too, if you feel you're in the need of them. Okay. We haven't got far to go now. 6 months at Sisica Penitentiary, awaiting a hanging for a murder you did not commit. Must have felt a whole lot longer, my friend. You still seem strong, though. I mean, doesn't look like breaking all those rocks has left you entirely broken, in body or in spirit.
Looks like I find out what I did.
Rounding you folks up, and those sham trials, they were a disgrace. Made a mockery of the rule of law. Still can't quite believe they got away with it. There's others convicted when you were. Came out breathing fire. Maybe you're like that too. Guess we'll see. You're just up here. There's the camp. Get your horse. Come on, hitch up. This way. She's anxious to meet you. Madam, we're back.
Hello. Jessica, the clerk, how do you do? What did you tell him?
Nothing, as we discussed.
Thank you, Hawley. I do hope we haven't inconvenienced you dreadfully. But seeing as you were due to be hanged in a week, I'm sure you don't object too strongly. I know you're innocent. Well, not perhaps exactly innocent, but not guilty of what you were accused. I know you and those who were with you that died were little more than patsies, and that you were set up by one of three men or a woman, possibly by all of them. I can't be sure, but that is all I know so far.
And one of these people also made Mrs. Leclerc a widow.
And I will avenge my husband's death, so help me God. But I will not avenge it upon them who did not cause it, or caused it unwittingly. Anyway, I'm sure this is all a touch confusing and melodramatic. Where are my manners? Hawley, please show our guests to their tent and give them some fresh clothes to put on.
Very good, madam.
Then serve us both a little refreshment.
Certainly, madam.
Got me some fucking alcohol. Let's go.
Find a change of clothes in there, alongside a few other items you might need, a lasso, a knife, and a lantern, I believe.
Okay. I would like it in brown. What else can I get? I'll have that in like the ready color. Best. Have the vest on underneath with the coat? I can. Lovely. No suspenders, thank you. Go with blue. Boots. Go with these. Or should we have a look at these and see what colours they have? Go with that. We're going very red.
That looks more comfortable. Hawley?
Here, madam.
Brogan de Kula.
Your very good health. I suppose it beats dying, hmm?
Mrs. Leclerc's husband was murdered by one of his business partners.
And I intend to find out which one. Or rather, I intend for you to find out. And kill them. You're the only person I could possibly trust to do whatever it takes. Because you and your accomplices, you're the only other victims of their lies still alive. See... You walked into the town at approximately the same time my husband was shot in the back, but by another gun, firing different bullets to those you possessed when you were arrested. These bullets, this was their mistake. You were rounded up and sentenced to death, all because you came to town and didn't talk too much and seemed like you were nasty. Anyway, here they are. The people who run Blackwater. Mr. Jeremiah Shaw, banker, real estate speculator, and crook. Mr. Amos Lansing, ranch owner, speculator, and crook. Mrs. Grace Lansing, his wife, society patroness, lover of the arts, crook, and my former best friend. Teddy Brown, her disgraced brother, outlaw, wanted man, and still in contact with them. All I ask of you is your help in finding out quite what happened.
Mrs. Leclerc would like to help you get back on your feet. Get back to work.
Whatever your work may be, I don't judge. You want to rob? Rob. You want to save innocent folk? Do that as well. But you need me just as much as I need you. I think we all understand each other.
I hope we do.
Good. I look forward to rewarding you for killing those who made me a widow. My husband was a true believer in this country and in the West. He was killed for greed. Foul greed when there's quite enough for everybody. I don't care what your scruples are as to killing. I will take the full burden of that sin upon my shoulders. Goodbye, for now. Then Hawley, go introduce him to nice Mr. Cripps.
I think he'll like Cripps well enough. He's long past his prime, of course, but he hasn't gone entirely crazy just yet. And he will help you better than most of his ilk. Cripps, get up.
Hello, partner. Hawley.
This is your new boss.
Oh, pleased to meet you, partner. J.B. Cripps at your service.
We'll pay to get your camp established. Mrs. Leclerc is a generous benefactor.
And where are we headed?
Okay. So, I always like go. Boss, you're gonna limit me to the Great Plains, aren't you? I prefer tall trees, but the Great Plains will do.
Oh, sir. While Cripps is establishing your camp, perhaps you can go to the station and see the clerk. Then head to see Clay Davies. He's a horse thief and not a terribly nice one. Then meet Cripps back at your camp.
See you shortly, boss.
Good luck.
Okay. Okay. Off to Blackwater we go. I like how interactive this beginning to Red Dead feels in comparison to GTA's. Like with GTA, you can basically skip the tutorial like I did in Rags to Riches, purely down to the fact that it takes so much time and it doesn't feel like there's a benefit to doing it. Whereas with Red Dead, it feels like there's a lot more depth behind it. Like there's actually a story as to why you get let out and all that, those things, you know, and it really does set you up perfectly.
You must be a Harley's friend. He's one of us. He said you also were a discouraged man. I'm very discouraged. Disappointed Alden, that's me. Anyway, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. I find your reticence charming. Real charming. By the way, I heard you might want to earn a little money. Well, some gentlemen have been robbing our stages, and they are not part of the club, if you catch my meaning. If you can make them go away, I'm sure they will have something of interest to you. They're up in tall trees. See what you can do, okay? Here, by the way, a catalog. The latest issue just came
Thank
into
you.
This armpit from a land more civilized. And if all works out, well, my colleagues and I move around these stations as needed. And all of us are very discouraged. We will all help a fellow sufferer with pertinent information. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, that was so subtle, Alden. Nice. Okay. What weapons have we actually got? Carbine rifle. Apparently I've got another gun too. Oh no. No, I'm mad. Hello there, Chomsk. How you doing, Rodri? It's great to see you, mate. We got work to do for Craig by tomorrow. Let's do the research on those slides that were given to us, right? Could be just up here. What are the question marks, Jamie? Okay. normally it'll be over here, right? Oh no, be over here. Slideshow shit. What slideshow? Yeah, you can swear, dude. I don't care. Where in the absolute fuck is this thing? What's over here? The one I was just on about. Well, it was worth a try. It really was. Oh, of course I fucking mess. Oh my god, I'm... I mind, we're fine. Doesn't matter? Okay. Let's just loot these fuckers. Excuse me, I would like to loot you and have your shit. Yeah. Looting. Sorry. No. I didn't say you could fucking leave, mate. Little fuck. Right. Treasure maps. Let's fucking go. Of course. Fun. Go grab this. Mr. Horsey, where are you, mate? Nay, nay, motherfucker. Where are you at? Hello, Mr. Scrawny Nag. It's good to see you, my friend. Yeah. Hmm. Oh. Very helpful thing to get. As many of these as you can. I know it sounds stupid, but when it comes to doing moonshine, all of these can be very helpful for different flavors. I'm not going to stop every single time I see one, but there was a bunch, so I'm not even sure if they're actually used for moonshine, but still helps. Different flavors, sell for more. Okay. What we'll do is we'll go to a fence and we'll sell that stuff. My god. Right. Okay. So we want to go to abilities. I want to pick one. So I personally like that one. Deadeye is super helpful. I normally forget to use it, so. Oh, fuck. Can I not just, like, go in on my own? Okay. I was hoping I'd just be able to load in on my own. It is a sad day. There we go. Okay. Can we just go? God. I don't want to have to wait 6 years to do a mission. Alright.
I win. Did Horley send you, Pop? I'm Clay Davies. This is my brother,
Clive.
He don't talk. Maybe you two will get along better. Maybe not. Listen, I heard you wanted to earn some money. So, there's a gang of ne'er-do-wells. They are a bunch of degenerates, not good people. They're out a Man's Anita Post with a bunch of horses they stole from me. Well, that's a lie, but they stole them off the fella I was gonna steal them off of. Maybe you could get them for me. You think you could do that for me, Pop? Oh, look. Here are your friends. Well, good. Meet me at the stable in Blackwater once you have the horse flesh. And I'll pay you good. Oh, and Pop, Horley wanted me to remind you any decent work you can find, take it. But just try to stay out of trouble. Oh, and once you give me those horses, well, after that, we'll talk again. Oh, I do so enjoy these conversations. I'm used to them on account of my brother. Let's go, Clive.
Okay. Oh my god, as if I fucked that. I want this one. What'd you miss? Not a lot, just the main stuff. Now I'll ride ahead a little bit. Let's go, my friend. We don't wait for no fool. Only killed about fucking 5 or 6 of them, mate. What's the main stuff? That's a very good question. So we collected a catalogue. We are just stealing horses for a mission. We're going to get given one of these. And we also did a treasure map.
About you, dead right. Ain't that dandy? Get that horse hidden away, Clive, and ready to move out as soon as we can. All right. Here's the money you earned. Now listen, Horley came by and gave me a message. He said to go see your friend Cripps up at your camp. Now listen to me for a second. Any other decent horses you find, we'll buy them just as soon as we are set up, okay? Nice meeting you. You know what? Hold on, boy. I call him boy because I'm older. 30 minutes, he went black. Let's give our friend here back the horse. It's yours. A sign of faith and future business. If you want to buy any extras or sundries for the animal, head inside. They've got a lot available. See you soon. Come on, Clive.
Yeah. I definitely didn't pick that horse because I thought it was the nicest looking one. I actually didn't mean to do that, but oh well. Okay. Over to the camp we go. Oh, my camp's already here. Okay. Okay.
Oh, there you are, partner. How do you get on with Clay Davies? Horrible little wretch, in my opinion. Pop this and pop that. I'd like to pop him a slime bucket. Anyway, I've got everything set up. Well, what we have so far, place is pretty nice. I think you did a good job for you. I'll earn my keep. When you get too old to fight, what choice have you got? It's either work or beg, and I'd rather work. Oh, I saw Horley. Now, he wants you to come down and meet him in Blackwater when you get a chance. I think he might have some work for you. Oh, and while you're out on your travels, you may see some folk with employment opportunities. Good folk, bad folk, looking for a tough guy with a gun to help them. Up to you if you listen to them, I guess. I used to like that kind of stuff. One time, I almost helped a clown steal an elephant. But that's a very silly story. Welcome home. Make yourself at home. It is your home.
Okay. Okay, right.
Ah, you're back.
So. Not sure what it wanted me to do, but okay. Right. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to look at the benefits, because I don't know what we've actually got. Free change of appearance and a $50 reward. Lovely. Ability card unlock. How much is this to actually purchase with gold? Okay, 40. Ah. I completed this on my main account as well. That's what's bad. Right. Okay, so what we're going to do, one sec, what's this? Collect deliveries. Okay, so we want to go to Hawley. I'm correct. I think this is a good thing over here.